Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. Making a quick appetizer or starter is easy as saying EGG. So I'm going to bring my farm fresh eggs right over to a hot saute pan. So I'll crack my farm fresh eggs in a separate bowl. And what makes this dish so special, and this is something that we used to have on a little luncheon, maybe after church on a Sunday, would be just things that maybe my Nana or my mother would just pull out of the fridge and just kind of throw together. And it's almost like a throw together meal. I started with a little pancetta, little baby sweet Yukon potatoes. And I want to cut them down nice and thin so they cook quickly and kind of crisp up. Just want a little light color on the pancetta. If you didn't have pancetta, you could use a little bit of salami, soppressata, bacon. Bacon would go well. What we really just want here at this stage is a little bit of oil and the flavoring that comes from the meat. So let that lightly cook. And then for the shallot, just mince it nice and fine. So let that cook up. Just want to wilt the green onion inside the pan. Just break up the eggs. Whip them real well. Now, some people will put in milk in the eggs and even a couple drops of water. That's fine. Frittata, it really isn't that necessary. It's not so much like an omelet where it's going to be very, very thick. Frittata is usually a little thinner. It's kind of like an open omelet, open-faced omelet, if you want to think of it that way. We'll pour in the eggs. And what we're doing at this stage is just making sure all the ingredients are mixed in. And I'm actually whipping a little air into the egg. I happen to have some beautiful bocconcini, little mozzarella balls, which I will dot the top and just let them melt lightly right into the top of the frittata. And they'll actually become nice and creamy. They don't need to cook that long. Just let them melt a little bit into the egg. Now I'm going to top it with my green onion. You could use any mixture of herbs. I have some nice purple basil here, some fresh basil. Eggs are very, very delicate, so I don't often use too many dried herbs. I prefer to use even flat leaf Italian parsley, which really doesn't have a lot of flavor, but it doesn't really need too much. Because of the eggs themselves, that's about all you need. And because of the frittata, and I want the egg to steam a little bit and just slightly melt the fresh mozzarella, I'll just cap it just for about 30 seconds to a minute. Okay, as easy as that. You can see the mozzarella has just slightly began to melt and the water coming off the top. And the wonderful thing about a frittata, it always looks beautiful when it comes right off the plate. A little fresh ground black pepper, a couple drops of olive oil, and you can, like I said, even let this chill up a bit and serve it even a wedge at a time, almost like a nice pizza. But the combination of all the flavors and the potato with the pancetta, fresh herbs, beautiful farm fresh eggs, nice and light. Great way to start a day or start a meal. So there you have it. A delicate fresh herb frittata topped with fresh bocconcini. And if I can do it, you can do it. See you real soon.